first one tonight from Amy, Stars fan who comes along week in, week out. Big friend of Dundee Stars TV, so she is. Fine job at that putt drop there. Flicked in here, rebound off the goaltender. And this one on the stick of Rinaldi. Nice pass out the zone as well. And here goes Phelan. Phelan through, puts the brakes on. Sweeping this one through the slot. Out the other side it comes. Pouliot is there. Finds Britton. Oh, Britton has his pocket picked. All the Stars have won it back though. In close here, scores! That's the opener for the Stars. With 1:37 on the clock, James Phelan. On the score sheet, Dundee 1, Glasgow 0.
Well, that's a huge opening goal for the Dundee Stars in this one. And it comes from James Phelan, his fifth goal of the season. And we can see it here. Nice work by the Stars.
Well, mistake in the zone.
Yeah, mistake there.
Costa clan.
Yeah, but good work from Rinaldi. And Phelan to... pick that off and get that opening goal for the Stars. 18:23 left of the first period. It's Dundee Stars 1, Glasgow Planet 0. Long way to go in this one, but certainly always good to get the opening goal.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, lovely pass up. Nass is through. Nass goes through. Oh, fans on the shot though. And listen to the corner. Ingles will work this out to the point. It's knocked away, and a clan with a big rush through now. Here is Barry. Plays this in close. Oh, so close to crossing the line. Wow! Stars will clear this away. Fast and furious start to this game. Elmar trying for the tap in, and the goaltender has that one covered. Linscook is sprawled to shut the door on Jake Elmar. So, Mr. Ward drops the puck on the face-off. Stars work this in. That's knocked away from him. County will pull this in and break away across the line. Jordan County rips inside with this one. Chance on the rebound, and it's blocked on the doorstep. Clan have still got it in the zone though. Here is DeRoche, top of the circle, fires one, it's deflected wide. Villio trying to work this up, it's out to the point for DeRoche. Glasgow sweep this over, top of the circle, shot comes in, glove save for Carr. And Reddick, nice pass up, County makes his way through, returns this out in front. And the Stars withstand that attack, and here they come in the opposite direction. Rinaldi across the line on the left hand side, drops this one back for Britton. Britton fakes a shot, Dow shoots one. Oh, what a save. Great move from the Stars on the left-hand side, and Dow is denied. The Stars will break out the zone here. Up the centre for Elmer, feeds it across for Paratino. Paratino back for Elmer, doing a return of favour. It's Elmer in behind. Oh, try for the Michigan. Oh, he tried it. It's down Elmer. Elmer shoots and scores. That has gone in.
Well, he said he likes the wonder goals. There's another one tonight. Let's watch this back, Dave, and see if we can make any sense of this.
Elmer moves in down the right hand side. It's a massively delayed reaction from absolutely everyone. Yeah, there is.
Wow.
Well, I'll tell you, Mr. Craig in the spot, he knew it was a goal, waved the hand, and a power play goal it is for the Stars.
It sure is, and that is Jake Elmer, ninth goal of the season for him. Another power play goal, and unfortunately not good for the PK stats of the Glasgow Clan, but plenty of time to turn this one around, and they've certainly not been out of it.
Here's Britton, turns and fires, it's just over the top. Back in the close, and Nass scores! Spencer Nass on the doorstep, makes it three. with 8:07 left in this first period. What a start to this game for the Stars. 3-0.
Well, this one here, Spencer Masner adding to the scoreline, 3-0. Well, watch it back here, Josh Britton with some good work. He gets the pass, or tips that puck into the area. And here you are, Filio with a good assist there, Spencer Mas. He's right at the back of the net, buries that one. It's a 3-0 lead for the Stars. Spencer Mass's 26th goal of the season. And well, the Glasgow Clan are all at a riot at the moment.
Yep.
And a very unhappy coach, as we can see there on the
And yes, I think they are switching netminders. Yes, Lince Cook heads off. Conor Linden will take his place between the pipes. And that sends a message for sure. 3-0 the Stars, though. You can understand why that decision has been made.
Well, there's words between the goalie and the coach on the bench. Interesting to see. He's not happy.
Yeah, well, I mean,
he's not impressed.
His defenceman did him no favours there at all on that third goal, to be fair.
They were almost absent, invisible. Harsh one for him, but well, he's not happy, chap. But that's an excellent start for the Stars. After a big victory last night in Coventry, here's the Glasgow Clan.
Very crisp pass in here, Johnson close, Carr with a save, and plucked out the air as well. That is absolutely fantastic from Kevin Carr. Big foot race here, and Elmer has the pace. Elmer puts the brakes on, plays it across for Johnson. Fans on the shot, puck in down low to the corner, and Glasgow will skate this one away. Sonch takes us across the line. Driving in, Sonch, he's knocked off the puck, Callan across to keep that inside the zone. Stars lose out in the corner. Callan moves in, top of the circle, flicks one in, deflection takes that one wide of the target. And back into the neutral zone. Four on four. Stars run the draw, it's out to the line for Dow. Dow back into the corner, cross ice for Nass, top of the slot, goes wide of the target. Good effort though, Pouncey moves in down the boards. Nice pass out for Valentini. Valentini onto the stick of Dow, Dow moves into the hash marks all the way down low, he's going to pop this all the way around, in front, scores! Brendan Dow has made that goal for the Stars, and with 3:31 left in the first period. Spencer Nass scores his second goal of the evening. Dundee 4, Glasgow 0. Well, we check this on the replay. It's driving down. Has possession, skates all the way around, feeds it out. Everyone's looking at the other side and pops it to Nass. And that's an excellent finish. Goal number 27 of the season. Failing, working hard, knocked away from him. Kelly, good pass up, Pellick across the line, continues in, nice move from Cowney, gets us around, in close, scores! A reply from the Clan with 2:54 left in the first period. Dundee 4, Glasgow 1. It's a good move there from Glasgow, and certainly Jordan Cowney with a great move in there as well. Here it is here. And on the doorstep to redirect that one home. Good zone time for Glasgow here. Can they take advantage though? Oh, a chance out in front here. Oh, Cowney with another chance, and aggressive goaltending from Carr. And Cooney, his better chance, his first chance was a better one. Chopping at this one is Elmer for Paratino. And off running is Pouncey. Dow in the centre. Chance for Dow in close. Carnalainen shuts the door, goes off the pegs. You can't score now, even if you want to, the Stars. Bolton to Sonch. Sonch moves in, top of the circle, into the centre. Bolton again, fakes a slap shot, moving across here. Chance in close. Carr had the shot. No goal. Carr had the save made, but is not held on to though. And Clan, oh, what's going on there? That's madness. Cross ice in for Reddick. Reddick fires that one in. Sonj looking for a tip there. Didn't connect. Oh, the penalty incoming here. Oh, no. Mr. Craig waves Sonj up. Johnson giving chase to this one. Oh, the puck is under there somewhere, I'm not sure. Why there's no one.
Somebody's got it.
Yeah.
There it is.
Oh! Penalty! Now, Luke Lynch is emphatic in his opinion, that's for sure. So, underway then, 50 seconds left with a man advantage for the Stars. Johnson skates this through. Back in for Johnson, the give and go is good. Oh, he's wiped out there as well. Goes flying into the goaltender. And both refs with a hand in the air. Maybe a wee chat here. Nice, up the boards for Valentini. Valentini driving this in now. Top of the slot, fired in. Oh, it's bounced off the top of the goal frame. Chance for Nass again. Will pop out for Dow. 35 seconds left. Dow flicks one in, and it's a glove save for Carnalainen. Well, he got a piece of that one there. Out for Callan. Oh, fired in. Chance in close here for Pellick, but Carr has it covered. Carr is down. Has that one under his control. But what a solid penalty kill what was for Glasgow. That will give them hope for sure. Not conceding there. Frustrating for the Stars. 5-on-3. Followed by a full 2-minute power play as well. And no joy. So, Stars find themselves on a power play right at the end of the second period. It's out for Valentini. Valentini moves this in, top of the circle. This one go and scores. 4 seconds going on the power play right at the end of the second period. And Ryan Valentini finds the back of the twine. Dundee 5, Glasgow 1. Let's have a look at this one here. The face-off win popped out for Valentini. There's a bit of time. Skates in, picks his spot. And Valentini restores the Stars' 4-goal lead with his 21st goal of the season. And the Clan will certainly be annoyed about that. That is 5-1 in favour of the Stars. So the buzzer will go at the end of 40 minutes on Dundee Stars Live. Dundee 5, Glasgow 1. There are goals aplenty in the Elite League this evening. Cooney for Lynch. Lynch across the line, returns it back for Cooney. Cooney plays it back in slot wise. And now the Stars force the Clan to the outside here. In front again and scores. It's Sonch. Philippe Sonch hits the back of the net and pulls it back to a 3-goal game with 18:06 left in this one. Dundee 5, Glasgow 2.
Well, the only thing the Glasgow Clan could have done at this stage of the game is get the next goal and give themselves a glimmer of hope and chance. and it comes through the former Dundee Stars player Philippe Sange with goal number 5 of the season for him, and has that given a lifeline to the Glasgow Clan? Only time will tell. 18:06 left of the third and final period, and it's Dundee Stars 5, Glasgow Clan 2.
Well, power play chance here will make things very exciting if the Clan can take advantage. Fired in, score! Hayden rips one past Carr, and a power play goal with 15:11 left in this one. And that has made things very interesting. Dundee 5, Glasgow 3. Timeout called by Mark Lefebvre.
Yeah, very, very interesting indeed. We said if they get the next goal, this is well and truly game on. There is only 2 goals in the game now, thanks to Gary Hayden. Goal number 22 of the season for him, and that has resulted in Mark Lefebvre calling a timeout. You know what was said at the end of the second period, Dave, and he knew that they had the ability to score goals if the Stars let their guard down. And I'm sure he is absolutely furious right now. There's only 2 goals in the game at this stage when they had a 4-goal lead.
This game will get more tense as time goes on, I think.
It definitely will. And it's not what you would have probably thought was going to happen at the start of that third period, but yeah, anything's possible. Exactly like that, look. Official floating it there.
Sange to the corner for Lynch. Referee has to get out of the way very quickly. Going to come around for Callan. Callan knocks it back in. County back out for Callan. Callan will send this in down the centre. Carr with a save. Puck is loose. But this time, Carr has it covered with the glove. Top of the crease. 7:21 remaining. McKay gathers this in for the Stars. Nice pass into the centre as well for Nass. Stars are onside. McKay has got a bit of space here. McKay in close. Denied by Karalainen. Pass into the centre. And here comes Harms. Harms skates into space. Drops this off for Valentini. Valentini wheels this one round. Back in for Nass. Nass shoots. And again a save by Karalainen. That's a nice move there. Valentini and Nass combining. Face off Dundee's own then. Oh, nice work here from Johnson. Oh, Elmer. Pops this out. Big save and across the line. Big rebound from Karalainen. But it pops off. And with 5:34 left in this game, Carter Johnson makes the score. Dundee 6, Glasgow 3.
Well, that's a huge goal from a Dundee Stars perspective, a sigh of relief perhaps. You know, the Stars have been needing that, that's for sure. And Carter Johnson, as you say, Dave, with that goal. And goal number 10 of the season for him as well. You gotta think that's probably left the Glasgow Clan with too much to do.
Down low again here, it's Pellick in the corner. Popped out to the line for Bolton. Slap shot from him, loose off the rebound. Oh, Carr, amazing save from Carr. Scrambles across the crease and prevents a 4th goal for the Clan. Oh, Ronaldo will give chase for this one, he's got the pace as well. Gets in there ahead of Callan. Here comes the support now. Shot comes in there, just wide of the target from Britton. Moore, nice work from Moore on the boards. Into the centre for Britton. Britton scores! Josh Britton took his time, and somewhat fortunate, I guess, but we don't care. Dundee Stars 7, Glasgow Clan 3, 3:49 left in this one. Let's have a look at this. Good work from Moore on the boards. Picks out Britton there. Controls with a skate. Shot comes in here. And it's trickled off the skates of Callan and across the line. Nothing the Glasgow Clan can do about that one. But a seventh goal for the Stars puts this game out of reach. You've got to think, the 3:49 remaining. Finds Harms with this one. Playing it up for Valentini. Poked away from Valentini. Harms going to win it back again. Unable to do so. Lynch across the line. Flicks one in. It was so close to being in the top corner. And Lynch and Harms. Yeah, I don't think they like each other much. I mean, after all game. What I would say at this point is there's no point for either of these guys having a wee scrap. Game is gone. Seconds remaining. That's going to be that for this one. So the buzzer sounds after regulation, and it is a massive 7-3 win for the Stars over the Clan. And the Stars will move to sixth place in the Elite League standings. And we'll head over ringside, get the thoughts of Mark Lefebvre, who is there with Swanee. Over to you, Swanee.
Well, Mark, a huge 2 points this evening, right?
NASA 2 points tonight. NASA 2 road points last night, so a great 4-point weekend. We don't make it easy on ourselves at times, but we got the job done at the end of the day.
We'll get to that third period in a minute, but in terms of the intensity and the way your team played in that first period, was that something that impressed you?
Yeah, we just took advantage of our opportunities. I think it's just human nature. When you get 3-4 goals, you kind of go for a Sunday skate sometimes and take things a little bit lax and easy, and you know, and just get too casual. But then we let them back into the game. But like I said, between the second and third, they got enough firepower there to come back. But you know, we got the job done at the end of the day.
What was the message to the guys in that timeout in the third period?
I don't want to repeat myself, but it's pretty much wake the fuck up. That's what it was. But, you know, part of my language. But, you know, I think the message came through, and we found a way to get the job done in the end. We got two big goals there towards the end of the third period.
And this weekend, you pulled yourself back onto level points with Coventry Blaze. Next up, a game against Belfast Giants. How do you prepare for it?
Well, tomorrow's going to be a nice day off for everybody to get some healthy bodies and guys rested and back to work here on Tuesday and get ready for a huge game on Wednesday against Belfast.
Now, we promised the Glasgow Clan fans we'd ask the winning coach a random question based on the webcast. Have you ever had a Cadbury's cream egg before, Mark?
I have, yes.
Would you have it on a piece of toast, is the question, because that's the way they've marketed it this year.
Absolutely not. Maybe with a glass of wine, maybe, that's about it, but not on a piece of toast, no.
That's great, thanks, Mark.
Perfect, thank you.
Mark Lefebvre with Swanee ringside then. Absolutely not to that cream egg on toast nonsense. Quite right as well. So while we're watching that, as I'm sure you would know, man of the match for the Clan was Philippe Sonch, a goal and an assist from him this evening. And now we'll get man of the match for the Stars. A few candidates, as always. Spencer Nass with 2 goals. Jake Elmar, Ryan Valentini, and Carter Johnson, I think, with some cracking performances tonight. Could be in with a shout as well. We will see. Stars. Kyle Pouncey picks up man of the match for the Stars. Good to see a defenseman recognised. Quite often the forwards, just because they get points, but there's quite a lot of work goes on in defence as well, isn't there? And Pouncey picks up two assists this evening. So a 4-point weekend for the Stars. A win last night down in Coventry and a home win this evening against Glasgow certainly helps them in the standings. Oh yes.